Hello, this is Gil Eastman.
And I'm Mary Lou Novitsky.
This is the final rehearsal of a one-of-a-kind, one-time performance featuring deaf actors and actresses from all over the globe, including stars like Marlee Matlin, Linda Bove, Phylis Frelich, Tim Scanlon, Eric Malzkuhn, and more.
You can be a part of the electricity and excitement because we've reserved a front row seat for you at the Deaf Way celebration.
Watching that rehearsal brought back a million memories. Reading scripts, memorizing lines, rehearsing, making costumes, putting on makeup, standby, butterflies, the curtain opens, the bright lights, seeing the audience. Welcome to Deaf Mosaic. Yes, Deaf Way is over. Everyone's gone home and no doubt has been talking about that special experience here in Washington, D.C. My feeling is that Deaf Way was a big hit. The festival provided the most inspirational, innovative, and educational event in the history of the deaf world.
I wish there was a way to capture those 7 days in words, but I don't think that's possible. For me, the experience began here in this theater, being entertained by extremely talented deaf performers. Deaf Mosaic hopes that we can recapture the essence of that special evening. We've put together some of the most memorable highlights from the performance. Join us, please, as we look at
Deaf Way, a celebration. Thousands of deaf people from around the world gathered for this week-long celebration. Howie Seago, a major star of theater and television, helped set the stage with flags of some of the more than 80 countries whose representatives attended the Deaf Way. Sit back, relax, while we journey from the past to the present through the deaf world of art, history, language, and culture.
Am I glad to get out of that box?
It's so bright out here.
That box was too crowded.
It used to be different. We were able to move around comfortably. Now it's crowded. Today the world's a box.
Yeah, the boxes have gotten smaller. The elephants smelled horrible.
Is that all we do? Walk across the stage?
Oh, we'll come back later.
Really?
Remember the balloons?
Shh! They'll see you.
I don't think anyone saw me.
That box, dark. That box, dark.
That box,
dark.
Dark.
That box stinks.
Stink.
Stink. He signs pretty good.
Ouch. Did you see that? Say, I have a dent in the top of my head. Do you? Look, right there. He has one, too. You remember those headphones deaf people had to wear from the time they were young children? Over the years of use, they created a dent in the top of our heads. It's right there. Everyone, check your heads.
He's got a large callus buildup on his shoulder from growing up with deaf people. Deaf people are always tapping someone's shoulder to get their attention. It makes deaf people walk funny.
That's ridiculous.
Watch. Do this.
I'm just like you.
Show us.
Whoops.
Growing up deaf, he was always waving his hand to get someone's attention, and it stretched his hand.
Well, what about those body aids? When we were growing up, some deaf people wore extra large body aids. They bounce against the chest for years and deform the body.
Forget this. Tell me, what kind of jobs do deaf people have?
Deaf people can have all kinds of jobs. They are printers, tailors, carpenters,
but they can get hurt as a printer, tailor, or carpenter. What happens if they get their fingers cut off?
They can still gesture.
Gesture. No, deaf people aren't dumb. They're happy they came to see their international friends. I'm happy to see you, to meet all of you. It's wonderful to be understood. Enjoy the show. It's a celebration. I love the deaf way. The deaf way is great. Bye-bye. Bye-bye.
The history of deaf people is a history of courage and self-determination. Historically, deaf people were denied the use of sign language and education. What are you doing here?
I'm playing Linda Bove. See?
I am Linda Bove. Your dress is lovely.
You really think so? It isn't too short.
no. You really have the legs for it. Did you forget to shave?
Yes. Could you,
What's going on here?
She's zipping up my dress.
Get off stage. She's supposed to introduce the next group. Come on, out.
Stay here. You're handsome. We're a team. We'll do the introduction together.
You're lovely. You look ridiculous. Come on.
He looks lovely, doesn't he? How many think he looks lovely? See? They agree. He stays.
Ladies and gentlemen.
All the way from the Soviet Union, the Moscow Theater of Mime and Jest, performing a selection from Oedipus Rex.
Over a long period of time, a small cell changes into an amoeba. The amoeba becomes a worm, and the worm grows into a fish. The fish crawls onto the land and becomes a lizard. The lizard changes into a dinosaur. Then a pterodactyl. The pterodactyl evolves into a saber-toothed tiger who chases down and kills the antelope. Watching this scene are two humanoids walking through the jungle. They become hungry. They discover a banana tree and eat its fruit. It is good. The humanoids pile rocks by the banana tree, indicating it as a source of food. Humanoids gather, and as the group gets larger, exchanges begin between them. The exchanges evolve into communication. The communication expresses values, out of which grows culture.
And now, I am pleased to accept the assignment of introducing the next group. They are a talented and beautiful theatrical company who have come to us all the way from Paris, the International Visual Theater of France.
The Eiffel Tower has long been recognized as an architectural achievement. It's become a symbol of French ingenuity and her people's ability to withstand atmospheric and societal pressures. Building on the resilient will and strength of the French people to continue their great culture, love of life, and world leadership, we celebrate the 200th year anniversary of the French Revolution.
I am now happy to introduce to you the Japanese Theater of the Deaf. The Long Ball.
The squeeze play. The instant replay. The slow-mo instant replay. The end.
It is my pleasure and honor to present to you from Singapore, the High Theater.
The story the High Theater is miming concerns the common experience of notifying deaf people all over the world about the deaf way and showing how they raise the funds to travel to America to attend the deaf way. Some funds were solicited from the public. Some funds were solicited from businesses. Mostly, the deaf people themselves raise the necessary funds through individual effort. As well as through cooperative works, such as fairs. Thank you. finally, the day for departure arrived.
It has been my pleasure over the years to perform in many parts of the world. 30 years ago, when I was starting out, deaf performers were rare indeed. While there have always been deaf storytellers, they were confined to the deaf community, deaf people performing for themselves because no one else was interested. We have come full circle. Here we are again, deaf people performing for ourselves, but what a difference the years have made. Now, when we perform for ourselves, we do so by choice, having captured the attention and admiration of the world. Deaf people from all over the world have united together as one warm community. Thank you. Now, it's my pleasure to introduce to you professional American actors representing the National Theater of the Deaf at the Deaf Way.
The improvisation of a soda machine.